It has 300 pages of how, on both sides of the ball, you effectively run the pick and roll.
Got to be kidding.
300 pages in his coaching book on how to deal with the pick and roll.
And how about pick and roll defense?
I mean,
how about the same equal number of pages?
And I'll tell you this, you know, this is why the Chris Pauls of the world are so highly valued, because it doesn't matter what scheme you throw at Chris, he comes off that pick and his eyes are up and he's surveying, and in the most split-second fashion, running through a series of reads and making the right decision every time.
So here's the most basic play in basketball, and yet, if you go a layer deeper, it's maybe the most complex play in basketball. How to play it, how to defend it.
I'll tell you, they say the best things in life are the simple things in life.
Mm-hmm.
Pick and roll is the NBA at its absolute definition.
Oh. Young in the corner. That was enough space for him to convert the people.
And Young can knock those down if you give him the chance.
Wizards trail by 16. Burt with it. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Smith with a screen on Young. Neal, not going to go that time. Nice D from Shakenbeck.
You know, it's been hard for him to find the range this quarter, but I do like his aggressiveness.
Front run up, and Rondo hit the lane. And the Bulls lead by 18.
And you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
LeBron with the steal. Oh, Rondo in position.
Such a strong finisher on the fast break.
Yeah, and he's not going to let an opportunity like that get away. I mean, he's just going to go hard to the bucket.
So it's Washington now. Here's Burke. His last outing, he had 8 points. Screened by Smith. Burke takes to Beal. To the middle. Here's Mahimi. Swing it to the whistle. Contact on the way up, and 2 shots coming up. And all throughout a basketball career, you have coaches shaping how you play. Doris, in your mind, what attributes of a coach make them a good one?
I think there's so many things that go into being a good coach. Obviously, you have to have great X and O ability. You also have to convince NBA players that you have a plan, and they have to believe that your plan is going to take them where they want to go, and that's into the playoffs and ultimately to a championship. But to me, Kevin, it'd be interesting to get your take on this. I think they've got to believe you care about them as people as well. Your take?
Communication skills, to me, would be the number one thing. And some coaches that publicly appear to be very standoffish, cold, sometimes turn out to be the warmest and the best communicators.
Well, you look at a guy to me like Rick Carlisle, right, who's absolutely off the charts, and guys immediately respect that. And I think from a press perspective, he could come off as gruff, but I think his guys know, man-to-man, he cares about them.
And eye contact is a pretty big thing. And then asking questions sometimes away from the game, too. Would you not agree?
Oh, sure. You know, listen, these men always have lives outside of the NBA. They're no different than you and I, right? And so, you know, there's a lot to be mined when you're coaching people. It's not just about what happens between the lines.
Sorry.
Bobby Portis is checked in for the Bulls. Morrow comes in for Young. The Bulls leading by 16, so down to 4 for Washington. Wall and Beal, the incredible backcourt tandem. Morris paired with Gortat down low. And it's Mike Donovan to get the 3 in the small four.
Up a few more points for him there. This has been a one-sided game in just about every area.
In just about every phase, they have dominated. Lockdown defense, explosive offense. This has been special.
And Beal kicks to Morris. And here we go. Fast break. Wade's got it. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Olin.
Well, shake and bake in the last matchup against the Pistons was a driven man. He scored 32 points, and the points were just the start of it. He joined an elite few by walking away with a quadruple-double. It's rare to see any player put up numbers like that. It's likely a game he'll always remember.
Okay, Dave, thanks. It was a performance that has to have their upcoming opponents terrified.
Yeah, I think they'll be a little afraid. I mean, anybody who saw that game has to still be in
awe. I, again!
He accomplished, and
makes the three. The Wizards with another miss.
Plus eight in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
And Young, here we go. Here's Shake and Bake.
Oh!
With the rebound. Wizards trail by 18. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
A three-pointer is right on target.
Well, Markieff Morris has a scorer's demeanor, and he wants to be the guy and has the skills to match and be that person.
Young pass to Shirkin. Portis kicks to Buck. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. And counting, this shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
They are attacking the rim and getting great results.
Chicago shoots their
second
at the foul line in this one.
And really, they haven't been able to differentiate themselves from the free throw line on the season at about 76%. No wasted trips at all. They're taking care of business at the line.
All against Young. Morris with the spring for Beal. To the paint. Let's it go from 11. And he didn't get quite enough under that one. Now the Bulls with it. They're on a 14-6 run. And the shot goes in. Butler's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And the interior D is really starting to be exposed here. How many layups have they gotten today?
Too many. Simple as that. Their defensive weaknesses are being exposed right now.
Beal gets a wide open look. And good. Coming off the assist by Wall. Yes. Wall's got 4 assists now tonight.
Found a wide open. He's been on this quarter. I love the confidence he's playing with.
Okay.
Morris with the screen for Wall to the inside. And they're going to pop the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play.
Well, the pick didn't exactly neutralize the defender, but good concentration on the finish to still get the basket.
From a broadcasting perspective, notice just how global has the game of basketball grown with advances in the accessibility of the games being played.
You know what I marvel at is how the next generation consumes sports content. Live sports are still what the viewer wants, but you'll see so many people watching on mobile devices, right? Small tablets, phones. It's incredible to me how different our business is, Kevin. News is now not on newspaper story. News is put on social media.
Don't you think, Doris, it's promoted that way too? Because owners in this league that are very in tune with the tech side of the business.
So many of them are businessmen and have succeeded because they've been visionaries in their field, and certainly they want to know, how is our content getting to that next generation?
Good point. And a look here at the assist contributions of Prez and Justice Young. This season, assist per game. Orange juice is one slice of the orange, and the other slice, the rest of the team.
Well, this chart just helps back up what many have been saying about how improved the ball movement of the team is with OJ out on the floor. They might not always make the flashiest pass, but more often than not, they're going to do the little things to set teammates in a position to succeed.
He feeds it to Beal. Bucket six. Launches it. Here's Torchot. He made that
one.
He's also missed two.
Now we know he's in the upper echelon of offensive rebounders. Torchot always working on the interior.
Young pass by Shirkin.
Kevin, where he is tough to stop when he gets to the rim.
And great, he can get up a few notches higher. Ball kicks to Bogdanovich. Works out with a spring on Buck. There's Bogdanovich. Chicago grabs the miss. Shake and Bake's got 6 rebounds here tonight.
Andre, you want to eat, baby? Andre.
That's good on the assist by Buck. He's got 4 assists in the game.
And really, Young is really efficient at shooting the triple. The D has to be better guarding him from out there.
There's a screen by Gortat. Beal dishes to Morris. Got it. Good job in the low post. Morris has got 6 here in this quarter.
Just a positive force right now for these guys. And those team has fallen a bit short, it's not because of him.
Yeah, that one's put him over the limit, and it's so early.
Me creen, peor.
Careful. This could turn into a parade at the free throw line.
It's interesting, Bogdanović came over from Croatia a couple years back. He's shown flashes, Greg, of talent, especially offensively, but he's still putting it all together.
Yeah, I think consistency is the key for him. Sometimes he's aggressive, other times he just disappears. Does have good size and strength.
Don, did you drive?
From the outside. Also finishes well around the basket. I like to see him create more for his teammates.
And Don Kovacki is fouled, and he's going to the line for one more. Ryan has checked in for Morris. Bulls have been exceptional shooting free throws tonight, going 9 for 9.
Yeah. No, don't scratch up on my car.
Washington's on 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Ball passes to Mahini. It's tipped. It's Beal on the wing.
Mutata!
There's a screen by Gortat. On the clock, hooked away, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Wizards will retain possession.
And let's take a look now at the stats for Shake and Bake. The past month has been surreal, averaging 41 points, 18 rebounds, and 12 assists. So much of what this team does revolves around his offense. They have been board dominant in this game. That's just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
And Bogdanović kicks the wall.
And
here comes the play. Shot by Butler. Nobody around. He doesn't hit that one. And Washington the other way now. Harris Bradley Center in Milwaukee. That'll be the last game of their very short three-game road trip.
They're a rough start for him, but he seems to have turned the corner here in the second period.
Outside, Wall. Outside, Beal. Five on the clock to the middle. Mahini's got 5 points so far.
Well, terrific secondary playmaker. Beal with a nice find.
Passes it to Shaken. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Butler in the corner. Here's Shaken Bake. Gortat comes up with the rebound. Gortat's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Ball's not loose. And Young, and here we go. Finish there at the rim from Young.
While not the most polished player on offense, you can bet he will attack the iron.
For Washington, they've gone 7-14 in the second quarter, shooting to the tune of 50%. There's a screen by Gortat.
Oi!
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot, he'll shoot too. Well, you just have to love the motor.
Okay, that's it.
They